Thank you. We can begin.
Okay.
Thank you. It's such a pleasure to have Kittu Gidwani with me today. I still remember because I'm, I think, older than she is. I still remember watching her on television in the days that television shows used to be fabulous and fascinating, and we had these amazing women on it. And then, of course, we went into a Sas-Bahu spiral and never recovered. But the the 80s on television and the 90s were kick-ass, you know.
Yeah, and absolutely.
And Kittu, you were such a phenomenon. You still are. But just to, you know, tell viewers, you know, shows like Swabhiman, shows like Air Hostess, they really allowed so many women to sort of validate themselves. You know, they could see themselves. We were all sort of getting used to a new kind of India, liberalized India. We could see that, you know, you could be independent, you could be a working woman, you could go to a new city, set up life, follow life, you know, set up an independent life. So it really allowed us to, you know, see ourselves on screen. And I think that gave us so much power and so much confidence. So thank you so much for that. And let's come to where we are now, where I think we're in a new age where it's just perfect for you again. So it's really lovely how life comes full circle. And you just have to be patient, I think, and keep yourself ready and open. And here you are again. So that's
exactly what I was telling another journalist yesterday, that in 2000, a new era started in Indian television and I had to immediately drop out.
Yeah.
Because I suddenly realized that there is no place for me in this scenario. And I think television has failed India for 20 years.
Yes, I agree with
because
you.
Because you're talking about an extremely powerful medium which reaches every village in India. Right. And instead of showing good content like in the 80s and 90s, which was perfectly acceptable in terms of entertainment as well as social messaging, as well as just relaxation, a good combination of everything. There were historical series like Tamas by Govindji. There was Shyam Benegal making fabulous stuff. And there was also Banegi Apni Baat, there was Swabhiman, there was Junoon, there were detective series, there was Air Hostess. I mean, the variety was amazing. That's why I joined television, because I thought it was more meaningful than cinema in those days.
It was.
Apart from
a handful.
So I think I did a great job, and I think television did a great job, and then it failed India in 2000, just went somewhere else.
Yeah.
And I think that people of India deserve better.
Yeah. I'm so glad you're saying that, Kittu, because it needs to be emphasized again and again. We have really, I mean, as you said, television has really let us down. What happened? You were so much part of everything. And suddenly, you know, television, the places where decisions were taken, new faces came in, new ideas came in. What happened? There was no place
greed.
For...
Yeah. One word, greed.
Greed.
So I think greed is not a good word, but I think that everyone is making money. Everyone is in it for money,
yeah.
Right? I'm not doing anything for charity. But the thing is that at the end of the day, 100 years down the line, what is going to be remembered?
Yeah.
Are those horrible serials going to be remembered? Is your bank balance going to be remembered? No. It's only good content, ideas.
Right.
Whether it's humorous, sad, pathos, whatever. Right? So for me, it's all about, hey, 100 years down the line, is anyone even going to know whether Kittu Gidwani existed or not?
They will, when there's a time capsule and they watch some of your shows.
So that's what I'm saying. Is that a consideration in your life or not? You have to make up your mind.
Right.
So, I mean, I just think that now, you're like you said, it's getting a little hopeful. Who knows how long it will last? But like you said, everything goes around in circles.
Yeah. So, Ketu, let's talk a little about where we are now. How do you see this? Because while on the surface it looks very shiny and wonderful and lots of opportunities, it's not all that perfect as well, isn't it?
I don't know if anything can be perfect, Kaveri. I do definitely think that the kind of roles I'm being offered are very, very interesting.
Right.
And they are obviously because of exposure to the West and the content made by Netflix and Amazon. And also other stuff from America and the UK and all that. And other countries as well. We're getting exposed.
Yeah.
So I do think that plays a certain amount, a certain part. And I do think that there's a whole lot of talent that has been suppressed for 20 years, which is like kind of, you know, just trying to breathe.
Right.
So, yeah. So it's just coming out, you know, because people are like gasping for air. And I think that maybe that's the phenomenon that is driving it. And I'm hoping that, again, the powers that be, you know, I hate that word, but it's unfortunately so much a part of our existence nowadays. I think that the powers that be have to take that ball and run with it and not hide behind their desks and their bottom lines again. You know, so I'm hoping that we can only hope that that we really produce some excellent content. And so far, we've been producing pretty good stuff.
Right. So what is exciting you now, Ketu? When someone offers you something, what are you looking for? Because you seem to have done it all, right?
Oh, Kaveri, I've not done it all. I think I have a good 20 years left to offer.
And, oh, yeah. Much more.
And I feel that I'm improving as an actress day by day, and I'm ready to really offer good stuff. And like so many other actors and actresses. And so I'm getting offered historical dramas. I'm getting remakes of very good Western TV series, the rights of which have been bought. I'm getting offered original content, like Potluck is one of them. Highly original, by the way. And so I am getting offered excellent stuff. Just did a murder mystery playing a down and out go-on detective living in a small village, for which I completely changed my physical appearance. And I thoroughly enjoyed playing a quirky detective. So it's interesting. You know, it's interesting. You would say it's like the 80s and 90s with a completely modern, postmodern ethos.
Right. And Ketu, what about the directors that you'd worked with? You know, I remember movies like Dances in the Wind, right? That's Rajan Khosa. Whatever happened to him?
He was Dance of the Wind, yes. Yeah. For which I won Best Actress in France, which everyone should know. I think he's working on some new projects, because an extremely talented man like him should get work. And of course, it's very niche.
Right.
It's very art film. It's very art house. And like I said, every artist should get to express himself, and every artist's work should see the light of day. So I'm hoping that he gets his dues.
Yeah.
But apart from him, there are so many talented people, Kaveri, so many talented people, writers and directors. Right. In fact, Rajshree, who directed Potluck, has done filmmaking in LA, and her take on direction is completely different. It's so fun and it's challenging, and it's perfect for someone like me who's been on stage for 25 years, because I love improvisation.
Right. And you've done a lot of it as well, right? You've done a lot of theater meanwhile as well.
Yes. So like Rajshree is an example. And there are so many young directors, the names of which escape me for the moment, but so many of the names that are told to me while I'm auditioning or I'm having a meeting are completely new.
Right.
Some of the projects are like, you know, older woman falling in love with a young man, and there's nothing wrong with it, and it's all beautifully written.
Right.
You know, so I'm hopeful, and like I said, if we take the ball, run with it, and make good groundbreaking content, I think that the Indian public will watch.
Yeah, I think in the name of the Indian public, as you said, we've done them a disservice because we assume that they don't want to watch something. We don't know. Nobody knows anything, right?
Yeah, because that's what I've always been told. But that's what the audience wants. Yeah. But hello, the audience watched Tamas. The audience watched Benegal Ji's, the one which he did, the history, India? The one about India? Discovery of India, the audience watched Banegi Apne Baat, Ye Jo Hai Zindagi, Swabhiman, Junoon, and all the other famous TV series, they watched. They were the same audience. In fact, Doordarshan was the one with the widest reach.
Right.
So the audience watched that as well. So, you know, it's not fair to say that the Indian audience only wants those same Sas Bahu serials and all that. I think that they will watch everything.
Yeah. How is it to keep yourself going while the world around you doesn't seem to understand, you know, what you want, or you seem to be out of sync, or the world seems to be out of sync? Is it difficult sometimes? How do you keep yourself ready mentally and physically, because an actor's instrument is his body and his soul, or his body and her body and her soul. How do you keep yourself ready and going and mentally and physically prepared for that moment which will return? And you have to be confident that it will return and you will be again the flavor of the season.
I think everyone has their own way of keeping sane and healthy. Because I have so many interests, I can do stage when I don't have any film or TV work. I can, because that's my first love. So for me, being on stage is more of a thrill than being on film or television. So for me, I can do that. It is tough for an actor because it's such a competitive world. To have a good support system is extremely important so that you don't fall through the cracks or get drug dependent or get into depression, because that's a huge problem in our community.
Right. For sure.
You need a good support system. You need to have faith in yourself, and you have to also know when to quit. It's not a question of hanging on, you know, like Gloria Swanson in Sunset Boulevard, you know, becoming a psycho, you know, or whatever. So you have to learn when to quit as well.
Right.
If you realize it's not working out for you and it's leading you into an unhealthy direction, the world is huge. I've always told myself the world is huge. Life is huge. You know, life has so much to offer you that you don't have to get your validation. Many actors are in it only for fame and glory or whatever, and those are not my motivations at all. They've never been my motivations.
Right.
To be in it for just for fame and popularity is leading you in a wrong direction, I feel. And so if you're in it for the wrong reasons, then you will not last. If you're in it for the right reasons, you can work till you're 90.
Right. Or till you're 100, like Zora Sehgal. I was reading a biography. She acted till she was 100. Yeah, amazing.
Almost till her dying days. And the thing is that, what keeps you alive at the end of the day? You know, acting is only one part of your existence. So support system, mental health, try different activities. If you want to write a screenplay. You know, it's any artist like this stuff. Any artist, whether it's a writer or a painter or a film director or a dancer, any artist's life is tough and lonely. So I have a lot of sympathy for my actor friends. And this whole slamming of Bollywood rubbish that has been going on for the last 2 years is such a disingenuous, hypocritical, meme. Because at the end of the day, you do turn to actors and films for entertainment.
Right.
So to suddenly say that Bollywood is everything that's wrong with India and there's something wrong and it's full of drugs, and I've never understood this. Because most actors I've met for the last 30 years are amazing people. They're hardworking. They're always trying to do another good job. So they're running for auditions. They're very full of fun and empathy. So, you know, I've never bought into this slamming of your fellow artists and slamming of your fellow actors and talking badly of this one or that one, or look at those people and nepotism. I've never experienced nepotism, or even maybe I chose to look the other way, but nepotism exists in every industry, in life, every walk of life.
Right. But it's also true, Kittu, that we hate the thing that we desire the most, isn't it? Because we're so involved in this world. There's that element of, you know, Schadenfreude, isn't it? We all want to see, you know, successful, beautiful people on their knees, right?
Yeah, I know. That's the unfortunate part of human nature, but I don't participate. I don't participate in that. And I always stand by fellow actors, no matter what anyone says about anyone, because I know what a tough life it is.
It's very, very tough. And you know, just the whole process, auditioning, you know, getting the right part. And then when you get the right parts, to make sure that you keep getting the right parts. I mean, there are choices at every stage, isn't it?
Absolutely. Absolutely. It's a tough job. And it's very difficult to be centered and find your way and not fall into the whole casting couch mode or the nepotism mode or, you know, things that lead you astray, like drugs, for example. If you're depressed, you will get onto drugs.
Yeah.
So you need a good support system. You need to have faith in yourself and you need to realize what your motives are for being an actor. Is it just to get famous and rich or bit... So life always gives you, there are always consequences to any action. Like for me, because I am very on the straight and narrow, I get less work. And so I have to deal with that. I have to deal with the fact that I don't run after producers and directors. And I'm just like, impossible for me to do it. I just can't do it. So every choice you make has a consequence.
And you have to be responsible for it. You can't then turn around and complain.
Yeah, I mean, everyone throws these weird things at me about this camp and that camp. And I understand that people are frustrated, but at the end of the day, there's free will, free choice. And if you have faith, most importantly, if you have faith in your talent, no one can take that away from you. Mm-hmm.
It's so nice to talk to you. Let's talk
We should meet up sometime and have a coffee.
We should. Let's talk a little about potluck before we wrap up. What's exciting about it? Why should we watch it? I'm going to watch it, but why should people watch it?
I think because it's hilarious and it does not, it's not over the top. It's funny. It's timely,
right?
And it gives you the old concept of, you know, family togetherness without hitting you on the head, and it's a fun series, and I think the fun really jumps out of the screen, and there's never a dull moment. So if you're looking for good entertainment, it's basically also set in the urban upper middle class, which is not very often talked about.
Right.
So that's another reason to watch it, because, you know, we do have something to say, the urban middle class.
Yeah.
Especially since all of India is aspiring to be urban middle class.
Exactly. But again, the urban middle class has got a bad rap in the last few years. It's been portrayed as, you know, the elite and the disconnected and the rootless. And it's pretty much got as bad a rap as Bollywood.
Really? I haven't noticed that much, but and I think that's again a very hypocritical idea, because at the end of the day, the country is trying to make the poor people become middle class. So if you're going to slam your whole middle class, then who's paying your taxes? Right? Exactly. We are bankrolling the whole country.
Yeah. Well,
so you better listen to what we have to say.
And you better see how we vote also.
Yeah, I mean, I find this is all people with agendas trying to pull someone up and pull someone down. And I think that every human being has a brain, and they should use the brain at least to 10% of their capacity.
The other thing is, Kittu is a fantastic cast, beautiful ensemble cast, right?
Absolutely, yeah. I mean, I know so many of them. Yeah. And let me tell you one thing, they are all crazy.
Ira, Cyrus, they're all nuts.
Crazy people, Shikha, all of them, they're crazy. They have amazing energy. And I think we all gel so fantastically. So it makes work so much easier, you know.
And there's a lot more that we're going to see you in. You talked about the Goan Detective.
Yes, we haven't completed shooting. That's also got an amazing cast. It's got Zina Taman, Pallavi Joshi, Suchitra Krishnamurti, to name a few. Again, a whole bunch of crazy people. And hopefully that will get a good release maybe next year.
Right.
And like I said, there are so many other projects which are in the pipeline, which I can't really talk about until we go on the floor.
So good to have you back, Kittu Gidwani. All the very best. I'm going to really watch Potluck the minute it lands and look forward to all your work again. Instead of watching you on loop in Swabhiman and Air Hostess. We have lots more to look out for. Thank you so much.
That's right. Thank you. Bye.
Thank you, ma'am. Thank you, ma'am. Bye.
I think everyone else is stressed out because they thought they were also...
She's left. I've said
next one.